Today we're talking about diabetes and pregnancy. So diabetes, when a woman develops diabetes in her pregnancy, it's termed as gestational diabetes. Also, some women have pre-existing type 1 or type 2 diabetes before conception. So they are considered as pre-gestational diabetes. So why is it important to worry about diabetes and pregnancy? And because as we know, diabetes in pregnancy can induce harmful effects both on the mother and more so on the growing fetus. So it's important that a woman who is already diabetic to control her blood sugars very well before she gets pregnant. So she has to really plan ahead her pregnancy so that her HbA1c, that is the 3-monthly average blood sugar control, is around 6 to 6.5% before she plans a pregnancy. And if somebody who gets pregnant and then develop gestational diabetes, she just needs to, it's also important for her to control her blood sugar levels, because hyperglycemia in pregnancy can cause congenital anomalies in growing fetus. So the main factors when we look at the treatment options of diabetes and pregnancy is to control the hyperglycemia, to avoid the congenital anomalies of the growing fetus, and have a healthy pregnancy. So treatment part would include mostly insulin, or sometimes even oral diabetic agents like metformin could be used. So diet, lifestyle, and if required, insulin may be used in pregnancy to have a healthy pregnancy and a healthy baby. Today I'll be talking about how do we reduce the risk factor in passing on diabetes to the next generation, that is in reducing the genetic risk factors. So as we know, diabetes is a disease which can be caused with genetic factors. When they are included in their genes, the risk factor increases by almost 30 to 40%. So how do we reduce this risk? So the main factors, important things we need to look for in reduction of the risk factor is mainly diet and lifestyle changes. The genetic factors risk do add on for a particular individual, but the main thing in reducing the risk would be because we cannot change the genetic factors, so other factors which are modifiable are diet, lifestyle management in terms of having a low caloric and a balanced diet, and with regular physical activity, eating healthy and exercising regularly can reduce the risk factors in a predisposed individual with the genetic risk of diabetes. So when somebody is predisposed, when you have a modifiable risk factors like diet and lifestyle, which you can do and reduce the risk factor in developing diabetes. Today we'll be talking about diabetes, and particularly is diabetes a family disease, to answer this question. So as we know, diabetes is a complex disorder with multiple factors or reasons causing hyperglycemia, persistent hyperglycemia. So there are many, to begin with, there are two kinds of diabetes, type 1 diabetes and type 2 diabetes. So these are broadly classified in this way. And type 1 and type 2, either of them, both can have genetic factors. So and that means to say, both type 1 and type 2 can have a family history to develop diabetes. So it's also important, not only genetic factors play an important role in developing diabetes, also the other factors like the environmental factors, lifestyle, and the physical activity do contribute or add on to the genetic factor risk in these particular individuals. And it's important to note, all of them with genetic factors need not develop diabetes. For example, somebody with a risk of carrying type 1 diabetes gene need not always have a risk of developing diabetes, type 1 diabetes in their life. Likewise with type 2 diabetes also. So somebody who is already predisposed, so who develops diabetes then? Somebody is already predisposed with a genetic factor, with exposed with additional risk of environmental factors like as I mentioned, lack of physical activity, eating habits, and environmental factors, which triggers on top of genetic factors, leads to development of diabetes. So when you calculate as a whole of genetic factors, type 1 carries about 8-12% risk factors when either single or both the parents are type 1 diabetes. And in type 2 diabetes, the risk is a little more higher side. It's about 30-40% risk factor when a single parent or both the parents are diabetes.